When defining a generic class or method, we can apply compile time and forced restrictions on the kinds of type parameters that can be used when the class or method is instantiated. These restrictions are called constraints and are specified using a where clause. All in all, there are 6 kinds of constraints. First, the type parameter can be restricted to value types only using the struct keyword, or second, to reference types only by using the class keyword. Third, the constraint can be a class name, which will restrict the type to either that class or one of its derived classes. Fourth, the type can be constrained to either be or derive from another type parameter. The fifth constraint is to specify an interface which will restrict the type parameter to only those types that implement the specified interface or that is of the interface type itself. Finally, the type argument can be constrained to only those types that have a public parameterless constructor. Multiple constraints can be applied to a type parameter by specifying them in a comma-separated list, and to constrain more than one parameter, we can add several where clauses. Note that if either the class or the struct constraint is used, it must appear first in the list, and if the parameterless constructor constraint is used, it must be the last one in the list. Aside from restricting the use of a generic method or class to only certain parameter types, another reason for applying constraints is to increase the number of allowed operations and method calls supported by the constraining type. As we see in this example, an unconstrained type may only use the system object methods. However, by applying a base class constraint, the accessible members of that base class also becomes available. As another example, we can make the base class generic and give its type parameter a parameterless constructor constraint. This constraint allows us to create a new instance of that type. Note that since the base class now has a constraint on its type parameter, and the child class's type parameter is constrained by the base class, we must also apply that constraint to the child class's type parameter.